Hi everyone, this is Lynn from She Crafty. Today I'm going to show you how to make carnation. Let's take a look at the tools and the material that we're going to use on this tutorial. 100% acrylic yarn in DK, any color of your choice. This is a color that I will use for my flower. And this is the green one that I will use for the leaf and sepal. Next, 2.2mm crochet hook. Foro tape, this one in medium green color. Scissors. Yarn needle. And wire cutter, I use them both. And thread, this one is polyester. Wire, this is the forest wire, is the 24. This is a gauge 24. For stem, this one is 20 inches. And when I come to use it, I will bend them in half and cut it about 10 inches. Okay. Hot glue gun. This one is narrow point, so I recommend if someone do not have this thing yet and about to buy, I will recommend the one that come with the narrow point like this. And for glue stick, I use clear color. Last one is candle. And the reason for this candle is to get rid of excess fiber. Before I start, I have to mention all my tutorials are created in US terminology. And the way I design this pattern is so simple. For the size of the flower, it will depend on how long you use your wire. So let's take a look at these two flowers. So the one on my right hand side, I use 30 centimeters wire, and this is how it looks. And the one on my left here is 15 centimeters. I'm going to show you how to make this small one because it make it quicker for the tutorial. So with this 30 centimeters wire, what we have to do, we have to cut it in half. What we have to do next, we have to start the same way when you doing change. So the way I do it, I just making the loop like that and making second loop here, and then push the second loop inside. Okay, next you put your wire inside here where you have your crochet hook. Then bend the wire down like this. So from here we will start to crochet single crochet. And the reason that I say single crochet because we're going to crochet on top of the yarn here and the wire. So this is the way we do it. You just put your crochet hook underneath down at the back here, and then starting to crochet like you do single crochet normally. You don't have to count any stitch, you just carry on doing the same thing like this. Okay, so when it start to get short down this side, you can just pull it to the right hand side and bend the wire down again and carry on do single crochet. This is what it looks like after I've been doing a single crochet for a bit. So before I carry on, I gonna bend the end of this wire to the back here in order to lock everything here. I will carry on until here. Okay, I think this is fine enough. Next, what I have to do, I have to bend the wire to lock like this. Okay, now what we have to do next, you turn the whole thing this way. Next, I put my crochet hook into the loop and making 5 chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then next stitch we make triple crochet. Where's the next stitch? This is your first stitch here. We're not gonna do on that first stitch, we're gonna do on the second stitch down here. So I put my crochet hook into the second stitch. Next stitch here, I will do triple crochet twice into the same stitch. Triple crochet, next stitch. One more triple crochet into the same stitch. Next pattern, triple crochet into the next stitch. Now, next stitch here, I will do triple crochet again, but with this one, I will do it twice into the same stitch. Have to make one more into the same stitch. Okay, let's take a look. I just got the yarn down here where it joined, so just ignore that. Okay, this is what it looked like. I'm not really good with the diagram, and actually I'm not really good about trying to write any pattern down. Many people asking me to do it, and I'm really sorry that I'm not really good with that. So hopefully that you not get confused. So let's take a look at the diagram here. This is the single crochet, and this is a wire that run across here, and this is a single crochet that we made. We just have 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 change, right? And next stitch, we have to make triple crochet, and then on the next stitch here, we have triple crochet twice into the same stitch. And triple crochet again, next stitch, triple crochet twice into the same stitch. So basically repeat the pattern until the end, which is here. So I'm almost finished now. This is the last stitch. And this is what it looks like after we repeat the pattern. So next, what we have to do, I'm just gonna put my crochet hook back into the loop and turn this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Making 5 chain, going to the next stitch and make single crochet. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Put your crochet hook into the same stitch here. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Go to the next stitch for single crochet. One, two, three, four, five. Put your crochet hook back into the same stitch. One, two, three, four, five. Go to the next stitch and do single crochet. Next, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Put your crochet hook back into the same stitch here where you can see the hole here. Just put it back into that stitch. So basically, repeat 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next stitch, make single crochet like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come down into the same stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come down into the same stitch. Okay, let's take a look. Here, this is what it looked like. Okay, so basically, please continue doing the same pattern as we've been doing until the end here. Okay, I finish. So the way to finish everything, you have to cut the yarn here and put the end of the yarn through this loop. Before we move on to the next step, I would like to show you something first. So when you start to do your single crochet on top of the wire, if you want your flower to be a little bit thick, you just need to pull them back as much as you can like this and carry on do your single crochet. Before we move to the next step, I would like to show you how to get rid of excess fiber with candle. I use this method on every project that I make and it seemed to be work out wonderful for me, especially if you use the acrylic yarn. Some brand seem to have a lot of excess fiber, a lot of bubble, fizzy, I don't know what the word to use. So let's take a look here. You can see This is how it looked like before I used candle. Let's take a look. This is what it looked like after I used the candle. Okay, quite happy with that. So next step, I will show you how to assemble them together. I will use yarn needle. Okay, next, put this aside for now. Let's take a look here. The way to do it, I turn them like this, just fold it like this. Turn it this way, maybe it's easier for you to see. Okay, here, turn it the other side to have a look. And then I starting to fold them circle. Okay, this is the way to do it. Okay, this is what it looked like. And if you're happy with everything, then you're starting to turn your flower here this way and starting to sew everything together. Okay, so I will bend this thing, this one, back here first. Put a needle like this, go across to the other side. Okay, and this is what it looked like after we finished sewing everything together at the back here. Next, what we have to do, we need to use this forage stem. This forage stem I cut into half, and I will use forage tape here to tidy up the area where I cut it first. So put your forage tape here if you want to go up, and then turn like this. And then come down. Get your yarn needle here. And what I have to do next, I put wire inside. Put it through. From this side to the other side. Okay, make a cross like that and then turn. Okay, and this is what it looked like. Next step, you get your fourth stem here and place your flower together like this. Try to push your fourth stem right to the top. Okay, then next step, I will use thread to secure everything together. Make the loop. Now I'm gonna try to move my way up here with the thread because I want these two to stick together like this. So just use the finger to help try to press these two. This is what it looks like after you finish. Use your thread to try to secure stem and the flower together. Next, what we have to do with these two wires, we just try to fold them up here. So I will start next, just use your yarn, the same color that you're doing the flowers. And cover the whole thing again with your yarn. You only need to come as far to cover the white wire, so just somewhere down here. Okay, not gonna go anymore below. Okay, I think this is thick enough, and then I'm going to cut the yarn. Okay, and this is what it looked like. This is not finished, so it's not look as pretty yet. What we have to do, we need to make leaf and sepal. Now I'm going to show you how to make sepal. We need to start with 6 chains. One, two, three, four, five, and six. Put it together with slip stitch. After you join them together with slip stitch, next what you have to do, you have to do single crochet twice into the same stitch. Every stitch here, from here to here. So I start next stitch. One more single crochet into the same stitch. After you finish, make your single crochet twice into the same stitch, you will end up with 12 stitches. So from now, you just carry on, make a single crochet every stitch. The way for you to grab this yarn here, you can see the yarn here. You want it to be down, so put your crochet hook and try to grab the yarn to come down. Okay, so let's take a look here. This is what I've been doing. I do single crochet into every stitch. So next, what I have to do, I want to check, is it high enough to cover the base of the flower here? So just put it in this way. I have to make more single crochet in order to go up there to cover everything. So just continue to single crochet. I finished make my support, so I want you to see what it's supposed to look like. Okay, this is how it's gonna fit into your flowers. So just take it out and finish the work with slip stitch. Cut your yarn enough in order for you to put it through. I'm gonna try to grab the yarn, so just put your crochet hook from underneath and grab the yarn. Move on to making leaf. What you have to do, chain 14. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Second stitch from your crochet here, from your crochet hook. Second stitch, you do slip stitch. Next, slip stitch. Next one down, slip stitch. Next, single crochet. Next, single crochet again. Next stitch, half double crochet. Next stitch, half double crochet. Next stitch, half double crochet again. Next stitch, double crochet. Next stitch, double crochet. Next stitch, double crochet. Continue do your double crochet. Okay. And now just cut the end of the yarn. Just cut the yarn here and put the end of the yarn. Oh, sorry, and put the end of the yarn through the loop. There you go. You have the leaf. Now the support and leaf is ready to be attached into the stem. After I make support and leaf, I put them through the heat again. Just use the candle to get rid of excess fiber so they look nice and shiny here. Next, You have to use the hot glue gun in order to attach everything together. I use the photo tape first to cover everything before I put the sapo. You can put the sapo in right away, but the way I do it, I just want to make sure that everything is nice and tidy. Next, what I do, I just turn them upside down. As you can see here, the stem and the flower will not attach properly, so you can move side to side. Apply glue at the bottom here, and then press your stem down. After everything attached here, I will put the sapo. Before you reach the top, I apply a little bit of glue. And then just push it to the top, and then use your finger to try to press it down. Next, what we have to do, you have to cut this yarn. Not cut it to be short like this. Please just leave it a little bit, like 1 centimeter, and cut. Before you move on to the next step, just tidy up down here first. Put your photo tape down like this. Try to work your way up and grab these two yarn down. With this carnation, I make 3 leaves. So the first one, I'm gonna put it here, up here. So the way to do it, to make it easier, you just put your hot glue. Let's take a look this way first. This is the right side, and this is the front, and this one is the back. Just put your hot glue a little bit at the bottom on the front side. Place on the stem here like this. And then try to use this 2 yarn and try to do like this. Okay, cut the yarn, leave it about 1 centimeter. The reason that I'm doing this way, because I want the leaf to look like it's wrapped around the stem. So next, get your photo tape and try to wrap everything again. Second leaf here. Do exactly the same. Put the hot glue on the front side. Okay. And then just use your floral tape to finish the job. This is what it looks like after we finish put leaf and sepal. With this, you can just bend it back to make it look more natural. So let's take a look at the flower. With the flower, I'm not finished yet because it's not in the position that I like. So I always adjust the petal again. And I will bring the hot glue to help me this time. So I look through the area where I'm not satisfied. Like this area, for example. For me, it looks a little bit straight. I just want it to look more natural. So what I do, I just put my finger down here and try to see that if I put it like this together, is it gonna look any different? And if I'm happy with that, I will use hot glue to put it in between here, not a lot, and then try to press them in the position that I like. Just press it down. Now they stick together. So this is what it looked like. Okay. Next, I just move to the different area, like this area for example. I don't want it to look like that, so I will use the hot glue to put it here to attach them together like that. This is my carnation. Everything is done and finished, and I hope you like it. And this is what it looked like here. So I find this pattern, and it's the way to do it. It's quite easy and simple. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my tutorials, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Also, if you would like to buy tools and the materials and get update on upcoming tutorials, please visiting my fan page, facebook.com/onechicrafty. Hope you enjoy the video and see you again next time. Bye.